Got that exclusive for ya. Ain't no conclusive around here. Cause you know.
Hi guys, I'm back with another DIY. This is just a quick how to do feather slippers that I've had for a minute, but I've been slacking, sorry. But it's pretty simple. I just got like some boas and got little cheap little sandals, flip-flops, whatever it is, and just glued it on top. So this is pretty simple. I just, you know, I'm extra, so I have to do like a big fluffy situation. But it's not much to really say. I used a glue gun, and then the boas and the slippers. So this was a quick DIY. My next DIY, hold on, I'm about to show you in a second. Yeah, that's the finished result. Hope you like it. Okay, so these things are, you know those like leg warmers that you wear for Halloween or even just like for fun? I found these in LA and I was just like, you know what, I want to make this into a bag. Plus I was going to a dinosaur show and I wanted like purple slippers and purple bag. I was trying to be a for real unicorn, which I succeeded. But this I just cut the sides down and basically just like sewed them together and made me a purse. I don't have the end results. I have it in my house and I've been meaning to like record or take pictures of me in it, but I didn't. So, but this is me cutting out the sides and then lining it up and just trying to figure out what shape I want the bag to be. Just take it from there. So enjoy. To figure out what shape I wanted this bag to be. I was confused, but I decided to go with a square bag. Super cute. I also added like a gold chain to it for the handle, which I didn't record, but you just basically just like sew the chain onto it. You get a local fabric store, but it was like this thick gold chain situation, and it came out really, really cool. I'm using like hair thread that I use for my clients because it's really, really strong when I do sew-ins. So I'm like, if it's strong for sew-ins, it's gonna be strong for this bag. So that's what I use to sew it. That's why the thread looks so thick. But yeah, I just sewed it all around, and I didn't even add like a zipper or anything, so the bag is pretty much just open all the time. So you can put like a little pouch or something inside to kind of, you know, if you wanted to feel more secure. But I just sewed myself in there while it was open. It stays closed, but it doesn't have anything to actually close it. But they know that's optional. Right here, I caught myself sealing the bag, like sealing it down just to make it look like I sewed it, but just kind of putting glue gun around it and folded it in so you can't really tell the raw edges. So yeah, that's optional as well, but I think it makes it look finished. Guys, for watching my DIY, make sure to give you guys 2-in-1. I have some DIY boots coming up with some like lace trimming. It's so super cute, so that'll be my next post. But thank you for all of these watching. until next time.